Welcome to More Sports Podcast number two. I'm sitting here with Walker Standler. Walker is a former Indiana University baseball player. Welcome to the podcast, Walker.
Thanks for having me. I know we've been talking about doing this for a while. I'm glad I'm finally able to come on and catch up with you.
Yeah, a lot of people don't know, like, you know what's funny? How we met 4 years ago. Can you tell, I can tell the story how we met 4 years ago, you know, sitting in the computer room. What did I tell you when we first met?
So we first met, I was working with Chicago Youth Programs and working with the MOLA, and I could tell right away that he was a charismatic, driven, entrepreneurial type of mind. And we're sitting in this computer lab talking about where we see ourselves in 5 to 10 years and setting goals for ourselves. And DeMola was doing a great job of that. And he said that I'm going to be an agent. And here we are 5 years later, 6 years later, and you're following your dreams. I can't tell you how proud I am of you, of how far you've come. I know it hasn't been an easy road to get to this point, but it gives me the chills talking about it right now, because, you know, this is a kid, DeMola, that set goals. People probably laughed at him when he told them that he wanted to be an agent, a sports agent, and be involved in sports management. And the kid has only done, he's worked his tail off to get to where he is today. And I'm very proud of you, DeMola. And it speaks volumes to who you are as a person as well, because you're obviously looking out for your athletes and the guys that you work with on a daily basis. And it sounds like you have their best interest in mind. And that goes a long way when you're working in sports management.
Yeah, it does. You know, we got some stuff working on. Like, I'm trying to launch my merchandise on Friday. With that, you know, make some merch for the players also. So we made logos today with their names and trying to put that on the shirt, get them to start making money with this new college rule, NIL, the image and likeness. And that's what I'm trying to get started with. I want to ask about your experience at Indiana. I know you played baseball. How was it like, you know, being a Division I athlete? You know, I know you didn't play basketball. You know, that's top of
your
mind. Yeah. So tell us the experience of being a baseball player, you know, at a Division I level.
Baseball is very different than a lot of other sports at the Division I level, because basketball and football, every kid on the team except for walk-ons has a full ride. And baseball only has 25% scholarship is the highest that you can pretty much get. So anyone on a full ride in college baseball, you're a star. You're an absolute star. No doubt you're going to get drafted and probably go to the minor leagues for sure and have a great opportunity to play at the big league level. But college baseball is difficult. You know, it's hard to find, you know, a program. I was fortunate enough to find a program like Indiana University that was happy to take me in. And what I loved about Indiana itself was the program was on the up and up. So when I first got there freshman year, we finished maybe seventh or eighth in the Big Ten. And there was a cultural change with the recruits that were coming in, the teammate, everyone was a good teammate that I played with. There's been a handful of big leaguers to go through Indiana's baseball program as of the last 5 to 6 years. So I was fortunate enough to, by the end of my senior year, we won the Big Ten. We won the Big Ten regular season. We won the Big Ten tournament. Wow. We won a regional. We won a super regional at Florida State. And we were fortunate enough to go to the College World Series, which is equivalent to the Final Four of the NCAA basketball tournament.
You know, you said you won a lot at Indiana. So, you know, a lot of guys in your position winning artists at college, you know, they thought about going to the MLB, the minor league. My question is, like, did you have plans? Like, what was the plan? Did you at minor league or the MLB?
I had dreams and aspirations of playing Major League Baseball. Unfortunately, there comes a point in an athlete's career, some sooner than most. Unfortunately, I wasn't drafted to go to the minor leagues and get an opportunity to play in the big leagues, but it's difficult as an athlete when you play this sport for your whole life and all of a sudden you get to a point where there's better talent around you. And mentally it was difficult to kind of wrap my head around that and understand that, you know, I'm not going to play in the big leagues, but it's time to start a career. Look at things outside of baseball. But what I was able to do is, you know, I'm super involved in sports still. I love following my friends that are still playing, and stay involved in sports in some form or fashion has been, very important to me in my working career.
You know, going back to what you said, you know, I did when I was growing up, you know, I thought baseball was boring until I actually played it. And I saw, like, it takes a lot in this game to become an actual great baseball. And I started respecting players that play in the MLB because I know when you play physically, there's so much in the game. You got to know the RBIs, strikeouts, mm-hmm. first base, yeah. second base, third base, the outfield, the right yeah. fielder, the left, the pitcher. It's just like, I was like, wow, like on TV, it doesn't look like that. But when you actually play it, it's like, it's so much fun when you play it.
Yeah, you notice that you got to do your job just like any other yeah, sport. Yeah, yeah. You know, like it's a team sport, although it might come off and look like an individual sport based on statistics and numbers and everything. But everyone's got to do their part, right? You know, mm-hmm. your center fielder's got to be ready for a fly ball to the outfield, and the shortstop's got to be ready to cut off a ball to get back in the infield. So baseball is very much a team sport. And everyone's got to be on the same page, just like football, soccer, basketball, like any other sport.
It's very relatable, very relatable.
You know, how are things going with you? What are some of the difficulties that you're running into right now with your company, and what are some things that, like, listeners and people like me can help you to keep moving forward?
Oh yeah, to keep moving forward. Right now we're trying to, like, make a budget for our company, you know, start making money, because, you know, to achieve great things, you got to invest into it. And I invested a lot of money into this. And I tell mm-hmm. a lot of people, like, you know, the amount of money I spend into it, I went broke the entire summer, like $5 to my name. So right now I'm just trying to make money off this. And, you know, I started this not because of me, it's for also get the athletes get going. Also, just like a, you know, trying to get everything all going at the same time with me and them at the same time. And we're also trying to look for certified agents to tap in with us, because you never know the kind of player that we have on board that is going to blossom up right away. Yeah, and it's going to look for somebody. You know, you're going to look at us and say, there's nobody certified on board. So me, I'm just building my name up as a manager to these guys, you know, working on their day-to-day training, giving them my advice, you know, calling them after each games, telling them how it's going. It's going great so far. No, I tell people the hard thing about this is when they have a bad game, you have to mm-hmm. figure out what you want to tell them. You know, do they want to listen to you tell them, oh, yeah, it's good, bounce back the next game, or you going to be hard on them by the way they play? So it's just adjusting to that life. You know, it's not easy as well. I got my own personal life to deal with. And
right.
Yeah, so everything is just a balance. I tell everybody it's a balance. So, yeah, right yeah. now we're trying to get certified agents on board, you know, get top-tier players, get this level moving up by next year. So by next summer, we're in a better position than we were a year ago. Everybody's organized. We're together, the team, everything. Like, we're already started making money. And no, it's not about the money. It was a passion for me. But right now, it's just like, you got to start making, you know, money off this. And, you
yeah,
know, you
I think just, a lot of the – I think some of the best things that you could do now too is just connect with the right people, mm-hmm. right? I think you were just kind of talking about that and connecting with certified agents that have been in the business. And I know I've linked you up with a few people that I'm familiar with that are kind of doing the same thing as you, and just learning from, you know, the ups and downs of the whole business and talking mm-hmm. to as many people as you can about it. And you're very, you're constantly looking to learn, and I think that's helping you, and that's going to go a long way.
Yeah, that's why I, you know, I may seem like I'm bothering you sometimes, but I always, because you know, you have the right connections. You know, I'm trying to build myself yeah. up. Yeah, because a lot of times I look at what you post on Instagram and stuff like that. It kind of I draw inspiration for that, because I also want to be in a position like that when I'm done with school. And by the time I'm done, this is going to be way bigger, because I started so early. So I already know everything right away that other agents have known. in the business. And with that, I also know that you have a great friend in the NBA, by the name of Victor Oladipo. People say I look like him, you know. Describe that. How'd you guys meet?
So he went to Indiana while I was there, and they're one of the managers of the baseball team is still his great buddy to today, and he goes on vacations with him and everything. But I think the first time I met him, we were at a party at Indiana, and he was just like a freshman, and I learned to respect him more than any other basketball player in the program because he was the hardest worker. He didn't have that many Division One offers coming out of high school, DeMatha and DC, and he worked his tail off. And by the end of it, his time at Indiana, he developed as a player, just like, you know, just like I would as a baseball player. He developed as a player and became a focal piece to the university. Everyone knew his name by that time he walked out of there, and the whole country knew his name too by the end of it when he got drafted fourth overall.
Yeah, but I first
Or
figured out
two, I think he went two. I
yeah,
think
he
he
went
went
up
two.
before, went up before to Orlando.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember the first time I heard of him was when he did that 360 dunk at Indiana, and it was on
Yeah.
ESPN. Yeah, so I
Against
was like,
Kentucky.
I was like, who is this guy? And then the name, you know, being Nigerian, I kind of related to that. Like, yeah,
Yeah.
he's so passionate. You know, as the taking up topic of sports, I see like, you know, your day-to-day life, what you got going on, global sales, man. You know, tell us what goes beyond the business. You know, a lot of people that's watching this could be interested in what you got going on, could learn some from you.
So I found a niche kind of when I graduated and I was done with baseball. I'm a salesperson. I've got to be talking to people. I love interacting with people face to face. And that goes a long way. Sometimes in sales, like people are reluctant to pick up the phone and just call somebody. And depending on what you're selling, it doesn't matter what you're selling. Over the last handful of years, I've been working in wealth management. So I help my clients manage their money. And, you know, I get to know people on a personal level and not necessarily just work. I'm actually very interested in what someone's day-to-day looks like, how their job started, how they like it. You know, do they have family, do they have close friends, do they like traveling? I think in our world today, I think it would go a long way if people were, you know, very actually interested in, you know, how someone's actually doing. Sometimes it goes a long way to just ask, hey, Demola, how you doing
Yeah.
today? And I think that's gone a long way in my working career as a salesperson, just kind of getting to know somebody on a personal level, and that'll go a long way in business relationships, and building lasting relationships is very important to me.
Yeah, growing up, I could also relate to that also as well, because when I was growing up, you know, I always wanted to introduce myself to people and ask them how they're doing, because you never know who you're going to learn from in the
Right.
game. Yeah, you never know what somebody has going on that you can actually take something from. Like exactly when I told you I wanted to become an agent 4 years ago, and you showed me all these connections you had. You knew Kyle Schwarber, the guy that currently plays for the Cubs right now, Scott, and Kyrie, the used to work at Roc Nation. So all that, just that's what I would tell people, like, you never know who you're going to meet. That's why it's important to learn how to approach yourself, because you know it was hard for
Yeah.
me, because you saw me. I was never that, you know, in high school, just I wasn't that interactive person, you know. I was just laid back, you know, quiet. But as soon as I got
Yeah.
older, I told myself, like, you know, what's that saying called, closed mouth don't get fed.
Yeah.
So it's, yeah, I just started telling myself that. It helped me a long way, because now I have what I'm doing right now. I can talk to you about it. You could connect me with
We
other
can,
people.
yeah, we get on the phone, you know, once a month, or we catch up, and you're a very outgoing person, and you probably never even realize that.
Thank you so much. And as a global salesman, what is the hardest thing you had to face, you know, with your company? I know you had some being a vice president and all that stuff. What's the hardest thing about it?
Right now, so I'm also helping sell PPE supplies like masks and gloves to hospital systems around the US. and the supply chain from overseas getting products and getting products to the United States is so difficult right now. Prices are high, and it's very difficult to get one product from point A to point B. Logistics are very difficult. And that, you know, I work around those challenges every day, all day, every day. But just like sports, you kind of got to stay even keeled, never get too high, never too low, never get discouraged. And I think that's something good that you can pass along to your athletes too, especially if they have a good game or bad game. I was just thinking about that. It's like, you know, you might have a bad game, but you can never get too low on yourself. Otherwise, you're going to carry that over to your next game, right?
That's something you said, because yesterday I was talking to one of my athletes that plays at Tulane. You know, they just lost really bad to Ole Miss, so I called him. You know, the reaction he gave me was not what I expected. He said, yeah, you know, they blew a team out a week ago, Morgan State, and they just got blown out on Saturday. So it's just like, that goes along with the game. You can't get too high, too low. It's just on to the next one, you know.
You can't carry that over the next week. Otherwise, you're going to be discouraged. And you're going to have a shitty week of practice.
Yeah, that's what I learned from this whole entire business. Like, you got to keep going, you know. Because there's days when it doesn't work out. You know, I've done so much stuff today. It just fails. So I just tell myself, like, let me try something else. We move on. And that works out. I go back to the thing that worked out and learn from what worked out. And, you know, all align everything together to make a perfect piece. And that goes along. It's challenging, but you just can't give up. And you just got to tell yourself that it's going to be worth it in the long run. And that's what I always tell myself.
And you know what those end goals are. And athletes know what their end goals are, because they should be sitting down at the beginning of a season, writing them down, and working towards those goals.
So when I first met you at CYP, you know, you came with Patrick, a couple of you guys, and you showed everybody the socks you guys made, Southview Athletics. So what inspired you? You know, I never really asked that question. Like, what motivated the whole, you know, beyond the socks thing? Because I also trying to make merchandise. Despite, you know, the shirt I'm wearing, I'm trying to get into, like, making socks, hats, you know.
Yeah.
Put a bottle.
Yeah. So our goal was, we all played sports. So we all, you know, love the flashy socks. We love to look good, feel good, because we're going to play good.
Mm-hmm.
So we came up with a Chicago flag design, and we had the idea that we wanted to, you know, work with guys like you at CYP and use our knowledge and our experience to help you guys grow as men. And I think we did a pretty good job of that. I mean, look at where you are now.
Yeah, you guys did.
I thought it was very important to give back. I mean, a lot of businesses fail. Not all of them work out. So I can't say that Southview Athletics, the socks, really panned out that well. But what it did do is allowed us to meet guys like you and all your buddies growing up, and just kind of give back. So my experience with, like, the socks, that didn't really pan out. But again, when you go back to just creating relationships and helping others, that was an aspect of our business plan that we took great pride in. And I think, you know, it speaks volumes that you and I still keep in touch today.
Yeah. Is there, like, we talked about, you know, the business didn't pan out the way you guys want, but you build relationships with that. Is there something you learned from doing that you could, like, tell me so I don't fall to that, you know?
Yeah. I think, you know, with business, and everyone has these ideas, and it's really about, like, putting the ideas and thoughts onto paper, which you've done a great job of. Think about it. You started from nothing, and now you got a full-blown business, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you're turning it into a reality. Because what your management company is doing is meeting athletes and getting their names out there and growing a you're growing a brand. And what you're doing with that brand is unbelievable, with giving back. I saw you giving meals out to the homeless. You're creating a brand for yourself that is only going to grow over time if you stick to it. Yeah. And those relationships that you're making right now with your athletes and the community is going to go a long way. And that's going to help your business, right?
Yeah.
So that's how I kind of look at it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Speaking back to giving back, we actually got another one November 24th. We're trying to look for a venue right now. Me and my cousin, we're trying to give, with the athletes as well, we're trying to give back, you know, Thanksgiving meals to families in need, give out turkeys and canned foods. And also have people donate, it's the holiday season, donate to Christmas goods we can give out to kids. They can have Christmas presents, you know, because a lot of families out there, you know, with the whole COVID, it just happened. Families are still struggling, trying to recover. So we're just trying to build that, be that, that hope in the community. Like, yeah, you guys can have a great holiday season. That's what we're trying to get planned right now. With that, when you said writing down paper, you know what's funny was that when I was writing it down, the first person I told was you. I texted you. I said, is the idea came during the pandemic. I told myself, I said, because I was watching Rich Paul on TV, and I was like,
Didn't I send you that documentary on Dawkins?
Yeah. I watched that, and I drew so much comparison with both guys, and I told myself I can relate to them, you know, in a certain way because of my relation, because I love to help people out. So with that, I just told myself, I said, you know, I always want to be a boss, you know, start my own foundation for generations so my kids, you know, can lay their own into it. So I said, let me just start a sports company. I never knew it was going to blow up like it is right now. I just told myself, let's just try. You never know. So I wrote it down on a note on my iPhone, and I sent it to you, and you said, how does it feel to write it down on paper? Not knowing, I didn't know it was going to blow up. I was nervous. I thought it was just going to be a thing I would just write down and just say, oh, yeah, you know.
If you don't write it down and look at it before you go to bed, then it's never going to come to fruition. But it's a testament to your dedication to wanting to give back, wanting to take care of your athletes, wanting to put food on the table for your kids someday. Like, it's very impressive. It speaks volumes to who you are, and you just got to keep going, keep plugging along.
And I'm surrounded by a great team too. So a couple of my guys, you know, my camera guy, E-Man, you know, he got his own camera thing going. He's going crazy with that. I just told myself the other day, everything just aligned to being great. Like my couple of my guys are doing camera work, you know, that's easy.
Imagine they're a part of the team.
Yeah. So I was like,
everything starts coming together.
Yeah, everything just started coming together, and I'm happy with the way it is going right now, and your help as well. You know, I know some days you're busy, which is what you got going on, and
I'm always here for you. Always use me as a resource.
Thank you so much. My last question, what should we expect from you in the future? I know you always got some plan, you know, a couple of your guys, you know, relationship with Kyle Schwarber and Scott and the Cubs, you know, and what you got planned? What should we expect from Walker in the future?
I'm always going to stay involved in sports in some form or fashion. Mm-hmm. I'm always going to look out for my family and friends. In the future, I want to just continue to be a resource for guys like you, share my experiences that I've had, and allow you to learn from the experiences that I've had. And I'm always trying to give back. I think it's important to give back to guys like you that have been a part of my life, and I hope to be a part of yours moving forward for sure.
For sure. With that, I just forgot what I was going to ask. I know Chicago sports is going baiting with the Bulls, the Bears, the Cubs, you know. How was your reaction when the Cubs traded everybody? You know, I know you got some players that play that you were close with on the team. You know, when they traded everyone, my reaction was, oh my God, we're going back to 50 years of.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was kind of something, in my opinion, that had to be done. Mm-hmm. All of these guys were going to become free agents. I think they could have held on to a couple guys like Rizzo, who's been a foundation piece
they should have
for a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah. And who knows, they might come back, but at this point, I think the relationship with upper management and the players, it ended pretty poorly. I think both sides were leaving with a bad taste in their mouth. But we'll see. I mean, Jed Hoyer, the GM of the Cubs, he's done this before and he knows what he's doing. And I think the Cubs fans just need to stay patient. Hopefully they can come out on the right end of it in the next years, 2 years to come.
Yeah, I kind of knew everything was falling apart when Joe left, then Theo left. Then I was just like, oh, yeah, it's the worst series that we won. Everybody was just leaving slowly, and we had the whole Anderson Russell scandal, all that stuff. So everything was just
It's black. Yeah, I forgot about that. Good call.
So the city's kind of black and white right now. So, so what do you – my last one before we head out is and I watched Sunday's game with Justin Fields and Andy Dalton. I know the whole debate right now, who should be the starter. You know, who do you think should be the starter? Because, you know, everybody has different sides. Everybody said Andy Dalton is experienced. Justin Fields needs to learn.
Start Justin Fields right now. Start Justin Fields right now.
Yeah.
100%. He's the future. He can get things done. What can't he do that Andy Dalton's doing right now? The only gripe is that he has more experience, but you drafted him at number 11 or 12 for a reason. Put him in there. Let him start next week. I would love to see it.
I would love to see it too. So Walker, it was great having you. You know, I have homework myself to get into. So it was good having you on my second podcast. It took a while, but it was nice meeting you. I hope I can keep growing with you as well. You know, learning the side of the business. You know, hopefully you can tap in with us one day, you know, then we can keep growing.
Keep going, Damola. I'm proud of you.
I got you one of these. One day I got to ship.
I'll send my address. I'll expect that one of those in the mail. All right.
Thank you so much.
Talk soon.